What's up? Let's go again. Another training session.
Another day.
How are you guys doing?
Hold on, let me actually get in shot.
Hey, what's up? What's up, guys? Hold on.
Let's get rid of that.
Yo, I don't. Percy, what's up? Leaving the lights already, nice, I like it. How you guys doing? Hopefully good. New Year's Eve, you know? Yeah, how you guys doing? Happy Friday to you guys. You guys are probably all home, chilling. So am I. We're gonna try to get a workout in today. Last session was pretty good. I just wanna change the zoom because the camera's crazy zooming on me. Hold on. There we go, that's better. Training last stream went well. I did a pool session after that the next day. Then a day of rest Thursday. And now I'm back, gonna do both push and pull today. What time is it? It's 12 past 6 in the UK. So yeah, I've just got back from doing all the stuff I have to do today. Now training session, haven't eaten. But got some pre-workout, the Viva Life pre-workout. We'll just get started. Yo, Sammy, yeah, it's going good. I don't know how strong I'm gonna be today, but still getting back into training after having like a week break. So we'll see. We're just gonna blast through push and pull. I have the Iron Cross trainers out. So I don't know if you guys see over here, we've got the setup, we've got the Iron Cross trainers. So you know, I was thinking, I had thought about, you know, trying an inverted cross, make them the easiest they go because they help with the lever, they make the lever easier. So I was thinking about trying it for inverted cross. But yeah, I don't know, we might try that, but we'll see. All right, let's get warmed up. Put the music going. Let's get this warm up going. Still gleams just as brightly in your eyes. I might turn the camera quality up a bit. That should make the quality a little bit better. Right, I'm still tight, and my chest still hurts from the other stream Tuesday, I think, where I hit my chest. Still hurts. We're gonna hit Iron Cross today again. Planche, bit of pull. But yeah, really gonna warm up the chest. My shoulders were quite sore yesterday as well, but seem okay today. But it's just all across here that kills. But yeah, how are you guys doing? How's your training going, by the way? Guys, good sessions. Let me know if the music's loud, by the way. I have it loud for me, but I don't know how it is for you. Yeah, the camera's good so far, nice. Yeah, gonna work out, yeah. just gonna get warmed up. I just thought I'd start the stream so I could just start chatting, you know, let people, because I didn't schedule this, you know, just let whoever wants to hop in. Seems like the music might be a little loud. Oh, you've almost finished your back lever workout, you've almost got it. Nice, Sammy. Nice. Let's see if the camera will track me. It always seems to have an issue sometimes. Let's see. Alright, let's go. Again, just warming up. Some scapular push-ups. About 10. Back to these arm circles. I'm already getting warm by just doing swinging my arms about. Let me see if I can get this off of my phone so I can What's up, day for you, Percy? You got your full punch presses and Maltese today? Nice, bro. Yeah, I haven't even been working on presses. We might start with that today, you know? Maybe we'll start with that. Camera lost me. Oh, it's still following me. But yeah, that's nice. Muscle up. A lot of people train today. I'm focused on handstand push-up. Handstand push-up, hard one. Takes some time, but you'll get it. You struggling with it at all, or is it going good? Yo, Kevin. How's it doing? I see you again. This camera. Yeah, I made a new workout program, guys, but I don't know whether to start it, you know, now or just wait till next week. I'm thinking I'll just wait till next week and just start in the new year. So maybe today I just kind of, you know, train, but kind of do whatever. But I don't know if many of you guys have seen with the shorts. I posted a short today about the one arm front lever, which I've been training. So yeah, I'm probably going to do a little bit of one arm front lever as well today. So you'll get a little bit of a sneak peek into how I train to like unlock that. That'll be kind of cool. You haven't missed much yet, just starting. You've been training for 10 years, Monk, and I can only do straddle planche with bad form. Yeah, I've been training behind the scenes. Yeah, Monk, you've been training 10 years.
I don't know, it depends how old you are, what your weaknesses are, because it can take that long, literally. Say if you broke your arm or something, you know.
You got some specific injury. So I want to know what your starting point was. I can do one, but I'm focusing on the balance and strength. Oh, for the handstand push-up, yeah. The balance is a key, but like one you want to get many reps in, yeah. It's a hard part of it. Right, we're chatting a lot. Just get the wrists warmed up.
I'm just trying to think what we'll start off with. What do I feel like doing? I do feel like a little bit of supinated, doing a few, because I want to get better at supinated. Of course, I just want to get my whole time up first. But I might just do some straddle supinated. Maybe we try some presses. We'll see. I still got a little bit of a wrist injury on this side. It's getting better week by week, but still, like, even in these stretches here, I can feel it. When it's warmed up, it's a lot better. But I can still feel it. I actually got the wrist injury doing one arm front lever. Like, the first one I ever did is how I injured it. It's kind of funny. Okay. You're 179 centimeters, and your arms are the same length, or your arms are longer, sorry. I have good genetics for statics. Let me check the... I'll skip this one. Right. Let's get going. Let's get going. We'll keep warming up as we do. As we're going. I want to get my, add a massage gun somewhere. Here it is. Got a massage gun here. Use that in a set. I need to time these, they're getting wobbly. Yeah, put a form up. I'm gonna warm up my pull as well. Do you do straight arm handstand presses? I haven't done many presses, but I will. I programmed it way more next year. So for next week, I'm starting the straight arm presses a lot more. Because it wasn't my main focus for last, well, it was at the start of the year. So at the start of the year, this year, 2022, I was doing it a lot. I was doing full planche presses. But then of course I wanted to work on form. So I stopped doing full planche presses. So this year I'm gonna go back to it. Yeah, handstand press is way harder than handstand push-up. Well, if you're doing it straight arm handstand press, let's warm up. Cool. I feel like I need more space. Just warm up this, like, this right wrist hurts when it's not warmed up. I can't, like, really false grip. It's a bit annoying how I can't force grip like that, but let's see if I can move that back. Yeah.
to an EO warm up, push, pull, and iron cross. So we're going to use cross trainers again today. I'm just going to use them to stretch my pecs. So these are really cool. You can use this for quite a lot of things and quite a lot of transitions. So they're pretty nice. I'm already boiling. Boring part of the workout, the warm up, but never skip it. A quick iron cross to inverted butterfly. Well, I might try not inverted butterfly, but I might try some kind of bent arm inverted cross, maybe. Something like that. Warm up the pull again. Might not be able to see this. It's warm. I saw some of the Elias guy YouTube channel, Guy Strong, gets inspired by gymnast. Yeah, Elias, his whole thing is that he wants to be stronger than gymnasts and wants to show calisthenics athletes are stronger than gymnasts. So yeah, check out Elias's channel as well. Street Workout Addiction. How many do you need advanced planche to apply to the straddle? What, do you mean for presses or what, holds? Yeah, what do you mean? What do you mean by that? So definitely need to warm up the wrist though. Definitely do. Warming up the wrist, man. It's never fun. Never fun. The workout's always 10 times better than it is. Yeah, This is also a really good one. Palms up and try and make a fist. Really good one. For the forearms and the wrists. Oh man, why am I so warm? I haven't even worked out yet. I'm literally boiling. Yeah, look, the front lever was with the heavy band, it was just warm up. But on the high bar, I can still do front lever, at least 10 seconds plus on the high bar. He means seconds to hold. So for advanced tuck, like once you get in there, near 8, anywhere is different for different people, obviously. But when you can advanced tuck anywhere between 8 to 15 seconds, or even maybe 10 to 15, more around there, that's when you're kind of getting more of a, you know, it's not a perfect straddle, depending on the person though. But yeah, I'd say around 10 to 15 seconds advanced tuck is when you're kind of unlocking straddle. Well, I've seen people with like 8 seconds advanced tuck have straddle. There's no set rule. It's all specificity in how you're training, what's weak. Some people have weaker glutes, etc. So yeah, somewhere around there. Supinated. A bit too low. Do some bicep warm-ups. GG, 10 second front lever. 10 seconds in the high bar. I've been doing front lever so long. That's why, once you get 10 second front lever, once I got it, I start doing touch front lever and harder front lever variations. So you just keep pushing and then it gets easier. Warm up the biceps. Guys, I don't know why I'm actually boiling. The radiator's on, but jeez, why I'm so warm. Can you show lower chest workout? Not today, man, for statics. How many stretches do you usually need to increase mobility in a joint, or is one enough? Is one enough? I think one can be enough in certain scenarios, but usually it's not as simple as like, oh, this one exercise will help. Usually it's more like, okay, like maybe two things are tight that's stopping you getting one position. So, and it's like, why not do a variety? It's almost always going to be better, but that doesn't mean one won't work. But it's always, why not do a variety if you have the choice? Right. Still warming up. Now again. Bit of one arm, bit of touch. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Feeling good, feeling good. Wrist is... Right wrist still can't really false grip that well. Please answer you. Any specific exercise to go from 4 to 10 seconds? I can do it for 4 seconds. Can you give me tips to develop it? Do you mean advanced tuck? If it's advanced tuck, I'd work on using, you know, light back. Like, you can already do 4 seconds, so you've unlocked the skill. So I would use semi-light band to just do like 20 to 30 second hold. Either that or drop sets. I'd do my advanced tuck, and then when I'm about to drop, tuck the knees straight in and go to tuck planche and hold that, you know, maybe 20, 25 seconds. You just want to keep doing more. Every session, keep doing more. Either you're adding weight to your advanced tuck planche or you're doing drop sets. You just need to keep making it harder. Don't keep doing just your advanced tuck. You will get stronger, but it will not be as optimal. And look at your weakness. Is it like your arm bending slowly? Is it your hips just dropping? So is it your shoulder strength? Try and look and see, like, or is it your core? Like, try and see what is your weakness, and then, you know, if you handle your weakness, you're gonna get stronger. Hey, Strumpy. Sup. I'm very warm. So on these, you can even do a Victorian. Super bad form, but you get the idea. So those are pretty handy. Pretty nice. Right. Chest kills from my cross still. We're only doing little today, I think. Oh, my chest is still super tight. Did you build muscle only with calisthenics? No, I did weightlifting since I was like 17, but I didn't have this much muscle. I've only been doing calisthenics the last 2 years, and I've put on more muscle. So not only calisthenics, but my recent like growth in my biceps and my back. My back is mainly only calisthenics. Like, I did some weighted rows, but they never really grew my back. I hate them. Once I started doing calisthenics, weighted pull-ups, then my back just blew up, like, compared to what it was before. Dude, what's up, Claire? Right. Stretching out the chest. And yeah, let's get on with a proper workout. So I think I want to try supinated full, supinated straddle, and maybe a straddle press. Yeah, more game with calisthenics, Percy? Yeah. Well, first is to supinated advanced tuck and straddle. I'm 15 and can do 11 pull-ups. Is it possible to achieve front mover till 17? Yeah. Yeah, everyone's saying yeah. 2 years. If you work on programming, work slow and try not to get injured, don't rush it, then yeah, for sure. For sure, for sure.
Possible, definitely possible.
Just work on trying to figure out what works for you. As soon as you can do that, the faster you can do that, it's basically like a cheat code. Okay, let's get my wrist wraps on. Thirty-five pull-ups, no front, because you know high volume of pull-ups isn't going to get you front lever on its own. Weighted will get you closer, but to get good at front lever, you've got to train front lever. Yeah, use bands. You need strong core. Yeah, dragon flags. What? Start working on dragon flags as soon as you're able to. Dragon flags are like, you know, 10 out of 10 for front lever and blanche. Right. How old are you? I'm 26. Still going strong. Forget front lever, I'm learning to dunk at 5'7". Hell yeah. Good luck to you, bro. Let me get you short. We got the press, we got the press. My form is not great. But I think that's because I knew I was going for the press. I wish I started doing front lever training earlier, because I can do 20 plus pull-ups while I need one leg front lever. One leg front lever, you're basically there. Jeez, you're crazy strong. Khalil Chia, thank you. Yeah, you're basically there, one leg front lever. Yeah, you're already really close, man. Bro, before you achieve the full planche, did you work on your core? Yeah, I did work on my core around when I was learning advanced tuck planche. That's when I started working on my core. How's your program for it? I have a whole video on the program I did at the time to get me full planche. There's a program or a video on the routine I did on my YouTube channel. I don't think it's the best to get you there, but it's what I did. But I definitely, looking back, I don't think it was the best. A lot more of my more recent routines, they're a lot better for many reasons, because I still encountered problems learning full, and I'm still learning. I'm still learning now, but I definitely think there's improvements. But it's the one that got me the full planche, so. You know, it wasn't terrible. Tendons are taking a long time to strengthen. Yep, that's just tendons. There's not much you can do besides not overdo it, so they don't take even longer to recover. What are the best three core exercises and how often do you train it? I don't really train core now because my core is pretty conditioned
and I train it every time I do front lever, planche, like basically anything calisthenics, I'm not always doing core. I might start doing a bit more, but at the moment I'm not. But what I did before was dragging flags, leg raises, hanging leg raises, and toes to bar. And what else? What else? I think those were the main ones. It's mainly those two. And then I do reverse hyperextensions. So when you lay on a bench and then reverse, that's also sort of core because you have to keep the pelvis position while you do your reverse hyperextensions.
So yeah.
Yeah, paleo. Oh, hold on, let me do a set before I got some more questions. Let's do another straddle press. I want to get clean form, straddle press.
Hold on.
Straddle press, clean form, let's go.
We're going to try a bit of a hold, but I mainly want the press.
We might just fully press. Like. Okay, that was, the press almost got stuck, but we got it. And the form, let me see the form, there was no hold. Yeah, considering I've not been training it, I am pretty happy. Considering I've not been training that. That's goal for next year, get full like that. But with a hold, that's the goal. So it's a good starting point. So kind of this week before I start next week, I'm just trying to gauge where my skills are at so I know how hard I can push during my workouts that I programmed for, you know, next week and next year. So so armored bar, I saw in many of your videos, you talked about the pain in the forearm after planche. Any tips to deal with it? It appears when you planche lean. Yeah, it's generally, overuse exercise. So you just need to do a bit less that requires the forearm. So any exercise you can do that doesn't rely heavily on the forearm to balance you or for strength, do less. And that doesn't mean do none, just try and do less or make it, so if you're doing a lot of leans, try not to lean as far, make it less intense and higher volume instead. So you actively recover, you keep training, we actively recover and then try and ice it, try and stretch it out. Like I've had times where it's hurting mainly because it's tight. You know, do you do forearm exercises and stretches? Make sure you're doing that because forearms is like usually a big weak link for people. You're training your biceps but not your forearms. You're training your triceps but not your forearms. So those things can help. How long have you been training calisthenics? 3 years, 4 years in total, but I didn't do it for a year. So really 3 years I've been properly training calisthenics. Why every dragon flag I do or front lever attempt is making my tricep burn for three days in a row. Yeah, you're using your triceps. You probably maybe slightly weaken the triceps compared to your back, so that's why it's kind of comparatively hurting a lot more. Okay, guys, so many questions. Let's keep going. Let's go. Cool. You're training for Iron Cross? Yeah, I'll give you some advice after. Let's do some front and some one arm. Let's go. So I'm gonna try and touch for like 2 to 3 seconds and then one arm front. Other arm. This is my weak side. Not bad, not bad. Okay, I'm training for Iron Cross. Do you have any advice yet? Make sure your tendons are going to be a big limiting factor in Iron Cross, especially when you start. So, you know, as soon as you can, you said you're starting now, start working your conditioning, your wide straight arm. It'll help with Maltese. So you can do, so here's some wide straight, so you can do Maltese leans, wide straight arm conditioning exercises, Maltese leans, you know, go as far as you can. You can do the Maltese like with rings. So Maltese flies, kind of like that. You're going down, stretching your chest, your stretch. You want to make sure you're conditioning these tendons by your pecs, here, here, and your elbows. And then, once you get the conditioning down, it's a load easier from there. Show two finger Maltese press. Maybe tomorrow. Okay. Okay, gonna warm up Iron Cross again. Warm up set. Chest still hurts. Still, but it's okay. Alright, but back to planche. We'll try full planche. Better to do pull-ups in a box, tuck front, or full front with a band. So I would say do both. However, what's going to be better is whatever's more specific to the skill you're learning. So if you want the full front lever pull-up, then you should be doing full front lever pull-ups. At least definitely have that in your training. You should be doing it with a band. It's like if you were training to get good at like cleans or something, you wouldn't do another exercise. Like, you obviously, once you have the condition and fundamental strength, but if you're trying to learn cleans, there's technique to it. So you need to start doing cleans to get better at cleans. So for the front lever pull-up, start doing front lever pull-up to work on the technique with the band. But also, there's no harm in also including unassisted exercises because they do feel different. And the techniques sometimes for some skills can be different assisted to unassisted, depending on how you're setting up the bands. So end of the day, try and do a variety. But if you had to pick one, then the front lever pull-ups, but make sure you, with a band, but make sure you program it so you're actually getting stronger. Don't just rely on the band. That's another issue a lot of people fall into. Yeah, you can tell the bar's been a bit destroyed. You should try gymnastics. Oh, I don't know, there's a lot of rules. It's very structured. I like the kind of freedom of doing, you know, calisthenics at home. Gymnastics is very, very structured. It feels a bit more restrictive. Right. Full planche hold to straddle push-ups. Let's try that. I always contemplate doing more in that short combo, but I'm always like, save it for the next set. Because I just want to do that. The form, form, not great, but it's okay. Wasn't terrible. So I'm always checking it back on my phone because I can't record myself using my phone. So I always like to look back after every set and see, okay, what was the form like? Do I need to change much? Yeah. But 35 of you in here. if you guys are new, what's up? I do a lot of calisthenics content on my channel. So if you're new, we're trying to hit 10K. You know, the goal is by the end of the year, but we're so close. So yeah, if you do like the content, then hit subscribe. And to think, at the start of this year, we were like 4,000, maybe 5,000. Like, yeah, we were something like 4,000 subscribers. So it's been a crazy year. Crazy year. So back to pull. Again, we're going to do the same front lever set. Touch to one arm. Right. Move the camera. Let's go. On the drop, you ready? Again, 3 second touch to one arm. Oh, the parallax! No! The parallax on the way! Ah, oh, I need some more space. That wasn't bad though. I need to clean up the... I'm meat hooking a little bit, especially on my left side. What's the best workout to get one arm front lever? From on the back? Nah, just a little bit, just a little bit. What's the best workout to get front lever? At the end or near the start of January, early January sometime, I'm gonna have a video on how I learned one arm front lever. So if you're not subscribed, subscribe, and yeah, that video is coming like early January. Cause yeah, kind of a lot goes into one arm front lever. Not a lot, but it depends where you're starting from really. Right, what are we doing now? I don't want to do line cross yet. I want to do more planche first. Maybe we'll start doing assisted planche. Or should we do another press? I don't know how much. Let's do assisted. Assisted, I think. I think I'll do. I'll do full planche. So much stuff in the way. Full planche unassisted. And then start doing assisted. So we'll do full punch unassisted, straight to assisted. Planche on rings looks funny, like weird? I don't know, I think it looks fine. Does weighted pseudo push-up help for planche? It helps for planche push-ups
And to some degree, and yeah, it helps with planche, yeah. But really, to get better at planche, you want to do straight arm specific. But of course, it's going to make your shoulders stronger. So if like your weakness is shoulders, then heck yeah, it's definitely going to help. But if you focus on more straight arm, then you know it's going to be more specific. You got one arm front lever because you have a high foundation that consists of touch, front lever, pull up, etc. In a month. Yeah, you're not wrong. The foundation always needs to be there. You're not going to get people that can't do like, you know, a front lever and then can't do a one arm front lever. You know, you have to have some foundation. But of course, still learning it. You'll see in the video anyway. Okay, I'm gonna set up. Actually, I'm just gonna do a drop set. Oh man, I felt tough. Not a hold. You were just rewatching Demon Slayer? Hey Anthony, man. What's up? Yeah, I feel like I need to. I'm definitely gonna go to assisted because already my shoulders are done. I haven't seen Chainsaw Man. Okay, let's go to front, man. Hold on, laptop's low battery. You know, my touch, you know, I'm feeling good today. Usually touch does not feel that great. Don't start it, it's a drug. Chainsaw Man, is it that good? Alright, here we go. How many exercises are you doing in a full workout for a day? Usually, I only do 4 to 5 exercises. Usually only 4 to 5. Actually, yeah, maybe it's more towards 5, and then depending on how I feel on the day. It's usually like minimum 5. Sometimes I do 4 if I feel weaker. And then sometimes maybe 6 of like, you know, I'm adding accessories at the end if I feel like I need to. On average, probably 5. Should we go to iron? Oh, yeah, I've set the camera up now. I'm just gonna drop this so it's a bit harder. Because I think next week I'm starting from either 4, difficulty 1, 2, 3, 4. I think I'm starting on 4. If you guys don't know, these are iron cross trainers. So you probably would have seen this in gymnastics. They help with the iron cross. They make the lever easier. So instead of you holding the rings here, the lever is actually here. And you can rest your elbow here. So it takes the stress off the tendons. So I'm gonna do a couple weeks of training like this to make my tendons recover, because your tendons take literally weeks to recover. So I did a lot of rings with a band. So I'm letting my tendons recover, and until then I'm working the muscle using these.
So giving my tendons a break from my cross. Level 4 out of 9. There's basically 9 difficulty levels. And we'll go to level 4 because that's what I'm going to be doing next week. I'm going to be doing long holds. Okay. Touch looked good, thank you, man. Yeah, it felt good today. I was not expecting that. Again, touch is not something I've been keeping up with, but not too much. But all right, go for a max hold. That's tough. I feel like I said, my chest already still hurts from doing this on my Tuesday. Big hug from Brazil, I love the channel. Thank you, man, Luis. Alright. Oh man, I'm thirsty. Right, back to planche, assisted planche. I'm just gonna shift this. Jesus Christ. Don't mind me just destroying my liver. Bands. I think we're gonna use yellow bands if I can find it. So yeah. Should have another figure around. Hope you guys are enjoying the stream. It's the greatest channel for Cali on YouTube. Oh, Anthony, man, thank you, thank you. Guys, if you don't know, there's I have a Discord channel with, like, you know, active people training calisthenics in it. So you can check the description of the live stream and yeah, you'll find people in there training calisthenics and posting their workouts and their progress, etc. Alright. What's my experience with dumbbells and espresso? And hello, yeah, CalSense01, how's it going? I've done it a bit. I'm doing great as well. Yeah, I've done Zenetti Press a bit. I did it for about 5 or 4 weeks. I don't think it helped me that much in that period of time. So maybe I should have kept doing it longer.
But I didn't see like a massive change because of it, I don't think. But that workout cycle, like, I did get stronger overall. I don't know whether or not it was due to Zanetti press or how much Zanetti press helped. But I definitely got stronger during that period. But yeah, I didn't feel like it did, you know, crazy strength gains, but it probably helped.
All right, let's go back to Paul.
Actually, I wanna just try Vic again. I'm gonna try like a tuck Vic using the cross trainers. Still hard. Still hard. yeah, don't have those on the easy setting, the iron cross trainers. But it's still hard. You know what, we're gonna make a bit of space. I'm gonna move around a little bit. Just doing a bit of cleanup. I'm gonna move so I have a bit more space. Move the camera there. Does your parallax need to be exactly under the bar? Yeah, ideally, yeah. So, like, my bar's like here. What's the best exercise that will help you through calisthenics journey? anything with a band? Probably that. Right. We're gonna do touch this way. So again, same thing for pull. Touch to one arm. But actually, I think I might do one arm with a band because it's getting weak. Just with the red band. Just so I get more time of attention, more volume. Right, on the drop. Send me some energy, guys. Let's go. Left hand first. You know what? Let's go to pull-ups. Good set. My touch is definitely losing the energy. How did I manage to build my biceps? I'm stuck with small biceps, I don't know why. After you train it 3 times a week, Okay, so for me, what grew my biceps when I was doing weights was very lightweight and doing like 20 to 25 sets, sorry, not sets, reps in a set. So I'll do like 25 of that lightweight, so basically high volume, so 25 reps, one set, rest, 25, until I just destroyed my biceps. That grew them more than doing heavyweight, like 8 reps. So if you've been doing heavyweight, or you know, you've been doing high intensity, try high volume, because that grew my biceps. And then also try weighted chin-ups. Make sure your diet's right, make sure you're sleeping. Yeah. And if you train it 3 times a week, make sure you're getting around 10 to 20 sets per week for the biceps. So make sure you're not only getting like, you know, like 6 sets. Make sure you're getting like maybe, yeah, anywhere between 10 to 20. Yeah, 20 reps or 20 sets is enough for the biceps. No. Yeah, I meant 20 reps for like 4 sets. All right, back to planche. So we're gonna go, I think we might go planche to Maltese. We're gonna do superset planche, Maltese. Alright, let's go. Yellow band first. Try and get my parallettes under the bar. We're gonna do another drop set. So add another band, go again, straight away. I don't know if I can do Maltese. These bars in the way. Okay, is this split good? And if not, should I change something? In 7 days, push, pull, rest, legs, and abs, rest. I don't know. So that seems like you're gonna have to do a lot in those 2 push and pull days to get enough in. Like, well, it depends. Like, if you're a beginner, 3 times a week is fine. Yeah, so like it depends. If you're a beginner, 3 times a week, I did that for like first 4 years of my training and still put on muscle. You just gotta make sure you're doing enough in those workouts to still grow. But if you're intermediate to advanced, you know, it might not be enough. So it depends where you're starting at.
Yo, Yasin, what do you think about training 3 days, then one rest and again? I just don't know what's better, 3 days with low volume or 3 times per week with a day rest between. 3 days a week with low volume. So 3 days in a row. I don't know, 3 days in a row high intensity is pretty hard.
I don't know if you'll be able to keep that up after like 3 weeks. You know, it might be like, but you can only know until you try. To me, it sounds like 3 days in a row, high intensity, then rest, is like not enough recovery in between. Because remember, you get stronger when you recover. So if you're waiting 3 days to recover, that's 3 days where you're probably not gonna come back stronger. You're just building up stimulus, then you're recovering and coming back stronger. So it doesn't sound too great to me. I prefer more rest.
Hope that makes sense. Okay, back to front. We're just gonna use red band for touch. I'm gonna move this back a little. Go out there. That was very meat hook. How many days a week do you train planche?
3 to 4. 3 to 4 usually.
This back. Hey, 32 people in here. Guys, if you're enjoying the stream, like the stream. We've got 5 likes. So if you're enjoying it, let me know. Because I started doing these streams more because a lot of people are liking the streams. So if you're new here and you like seeing how I train, then subscribe, because I'm gonna stream probably twice per week, pretty much all of 2023. Yeah, and if you're liking this stream, then yeah, like, name of the song is Whatever It Takes, Hard Star by Annie Lifts. Okay, well, on push days, I do 3 times 20 reps and do some handstand holds against the wall and do some more handstand push-ups. On pull day, I do... Yeah, but like, Martin, like, are you a beginner and are you making progress? Those are my two questions. Oh, my day is bricked. Useful, would it? I train 3 to 4 times per week, Neith. 3 to 4. Alright, planche, a Maltese superset. Long holds. Yellow band first. Red band, red annular, to Maltese. Yeah, I'm British, yeah. What am I even? Yeah, I'm British. Yeah, I make progress. I increase reps each week, but now for push days I have 10 games I do. Yeah, it sounds good. If you're making progress, it sounds good. If you tell me, my tuck punch, it gets hard. I do lean shooter push-ups, hinge push-ups, and like I said, handstand push-ups against the wall. It sounds like you need something a bit more specific. Like the planche leans are good, but also try and do an easy tuck variation. Try and start doing an easy tuck variation. Hey, Naveen, what's up? Ooh, how is the planche? Hope my planche form was alright, I didn't watch that one back. Right, back to pull. Let's go. Let us go back to pull. Okay. Now we're gonna try a supinated touch. And where should I do it? Let's do it like here. Supinated touch with a band. Can I show you the easy tuck variation? Because I don't know. Thanks for answering. Yeah, I can kind of help you out with that. Right, let's go supinated. Supinated touch. Am I gonna be able to do this? It's gonna be quite hard. Oh, not quite, but man, I hurt my wrist. This is gonna be the last set of this, I tell you that. Yeah, that's the last set. That, oh man, the supinated, that hurt. The easy tuck variation, yeah, let me show you. So, easy tuck variation. So you can literally start, so do your tuck planche. Well, it depends, it depends how many seconds you can already hold tuck planche. But what's gonna bridge the gap between leans, so make sure your leans are looking like this. You know, fully protracted. So what's gonna bridge the gap between that and tuck planche? You can bring the knees in and do leans like this. So you're still tucking in, and then try and lean a little bit. So you work on the protraction while you're tucked. So this is literally what you're gonna be doing. So you can work on that, tuck leans, pseudo tuck leans or whatever. Once you're also good at that, then you can start lifting your foot up, lift your feet up, so your body weight has to hold up more. And then from there, start doing pumps, so you get into this sort of position, then you protract and push, push, push. So those are all exercises you can do after your tuck planche holds. You're the best channel. Thank you, HT Gaming. Thank you. I really appreciate you guys watching. Yeah, I really appreciate you guys in here watching, enjoying the streams. You see, even like for me, that burnt out my shoulders. Like I really feel that. No problem, man. So what's next? I think we'll do some iron cross. Iron cross. We really should do some presses. Yeah, I don't know. I might move to the corridor and do presses. Because this is hard to do presses with. Just because there's so much stuff in the way. And I want to keep the iron cross things up. When to start training planche? Personally, I feel like you can start training planche really early. But I don't mean doing planche holds. I mean, you start doing exercises to condition your arms. So anything from like ring supports or even just dip support holds, depressing, biceps pointed forward, elbow ditch outwards, and then holding your body weight up. Any straight arm movement, I feel like you can start learning and just make it, you know, progress it to your level. Or regress it to your level if it's too hard. Because you want to start working the wrists and the elbows. So in my opinion, like I would start working on that. And then once you get good enough pushing strength, so say you can do 30 push-ups in a set, your overhead press is decent, or you can do pipe push-ups, then I'd start, you know, playing around with the tuck planche. And you can try some yoga moves as well. There's crow, stuff like that. That's bent arm, but still works the shoulders. Those are a good place to start as well. Now, skin the cat will help more with front lever. I'm gonna buy a pull and dip bar. Then I am gonna take calisthenics super serious. It's so funny. Yeah, it's really fun. Right. Let's do an iron cross hold. It's Tough, tough. We're gonna have to do barge presses now. Or actually, I might do, yeah, let's do box assisted, actually. Let's do box assisted. Or dip bar assisted. For pull, I'm gonna go to rate. I'm gonna start doing raises for pull. And then we're close to that. So yeah, box assisted. You're insane, you have a lot of strength, thank you very much. Switch this off. When I bicep curl, I feel in my bicep tendon, which feels like when I plant leans. Does that mean me curling will help my strength? It's probably just because you feel the tension as you straighten out. Will it help? Yeah, getting your biceps stronger will help in planche leans because you still have tension on your biceps and your bicep is working so you don't crumble, you know, that straight arm strength. So yeah, getting your biceps stronger, you know, will help because it's stabilizing that straight arm so you don't collapse as well as your tricep. Like, your bicep's not like doing nothing. You're kind of, it's hard to explain. It's as if you're trying to curl, but you're keeping your arm straight. You know, like you'll see my, can I show you this? So here's your straight arm, and there you see my bicep flex. You guys see that? You see that? Bicep flexing, even though my arm's still straight, that's what it's like in planche. So I'm straight arm, my tricep contracted, and then bicep. That's in iron cross, planche, all of that. So yeah, you'll feel it in curls as well. Sorry for asking a lot of Russian push-ups, Russian dipper on the side. Yeah, they're not very beginner-friendly, I don't think, the Russian dips and Korean dips. They're not very beginner-friendly or intermediate-friendly. I'd kind of leave them until you're really good at dips. Till dips are like really easy, you know, you're doing weight dips really easy. Then, you know, I'd start working with that, but I'd be careful with it just because it's a lot on the pecs. And you don't want to tear a pec or something, I wouldn't rush into those. But you could do things like negatives potentially and stuff like that if it's within your scope. Just be careful with those because they can be quite intense. Okay, guys. We gotta finish this up soon. Let's go. We're gonna try straddle. I'm feeling my glutes on that one. It's a bit pressing. Anything to help you get pull up? Bands, negatives. You can kind of do jumping reps. You can kind of hop into it to kind of help you and then do a negative down. Yeah, lat pull downs at the gym. Why does the bicep contract? It's really to help the tendon. Hold on, this music's loud for me. No, I'm gonna turn it off as well. So, let me take the arm. So the bicep contracts because, like, say I'm in the I cross, I could do it completely straight, no bicep tension, but all the stress has to go somewhere, and it's going to my tendon. And the tendons are quite strong, and that's why, they have a lot of potential to be strong when working with the muscle. But, you know, that's why you need to condition them to be strong, because they're not going to be used to that amount of stress. So in order to kind of protect the tendons, like in iron cross here, to protect the tendons, my biceps will contract. You won't be able to tell this, but the biceps will contract, and it will kind of help the tendons give some assistance, because all the load is on the tendon. Like, see here, like it's obviously there, it's going to my pecs, but like here, no bicep activation, it's all on the tendons and the chest. But if I contract my chest, contract my biceps, it's helping my tendons. At least that's my experience with why my biceps contract with these straight arm movements. Because you see gymnasts, why do brim gymnasts have such big forearms and biceps? It's because of the straight arm movements. The biceps help and assist in that way. Asking because I'm creating my own program as a bodybuilder / calisthenics fabric. I don't know if there's a point of curling and doing straight arm raises with a dumbbell. Oof. If you can't do this progression, does that mean my core is weak for the planche? Yeah, like Option said, it could be core, or it could be glute. Yeah, because when I did the straddle there, it was mainly glutes, especially in the press. Like, obviously my arms were doing stuff, but my glutes is what was really taking the brunt of the force as well as moving up and down. But if you're doing it in advanced tackling stuff, then maybe it could be something else. Right, we got to finish up. I'm hungry. Let's go. One, two, three, four, five, and but that is such a good exercise. If you watch my conversation with Tom Skirbinov, he suggested these a lot. And that's what you think? And it's just genetic. I guess, bro. Best exercise to start front lever, tuck, and other progressions included. So for front lever, dragon flags, tuck. Doing it with a band. Doing it with a band is like almost always going to be a good thing. Even if it's a slightly heavy band, just so you understand the position, what your body needs to do. Yeah. Skin the cat. Pike skin the cat. Scapular raises. I need to do some of those now, actually. I'm going to do some of those now. Oh, So with those, I kind of like to do higher reps, you know, like 8, around 8 to 10, not really like only 3. Do you ever do rotator work? To be honest, not really. I warm them up, but you know, lately, no, I have not. How close are you to Maltese, by the way? I've not really been training it. I was training at the start of this year, but because I'm training Iron Cross, I'm on light band. I'm on like a light red band for Maltese because I've been doing Iron Cross. My strength on strength has gotten a lot stronger, so I'm a lot closer to Maltese. But I think I still have a few months. Definitely, I think I'll be very close by like next summer. I think I either might have it or I might be like just that far off. Do you train the high pull-up? Not really. I train more front lever rows and front lever pull-ups. I do many hollow body holds. Yeah, those are good. Yeah, those are good exercises for core, man. Yeah, all those are good. All those are good. Oof. Let's do the last set. I think I've done like 3 sets of this. I need more water first. Yeah, Iron Cross with the band. In about 5 weeks, I'm gonna go back to doing it with the band. This is to give my tendons a rest and work the muscle all across here. That's why I'm using these cross trainers. Do you do weighted Cali or just train moves? I do a bit of weighted Cali, but not much. Yeah, I put all my focus just into the skills at the moment. I'm not really weighted stuff. But I was planning on doing some weighted stuff because I actually brought my weight vest up. But yeah, right now I mainly just focus on skills and programming them because I already have the foundation of strength. I'm just training as specifically as I can. But definitely for like, I'd say most people like you should program weighted. Let me move the camera.
Tough, tough.
Yeah, yeah, high pull-ups clean a muscle up.
I agree. Yeah, I agree with the options.
Oh yeah, yeah, I did weighted Cali before. So since I was 17, I'm 26 now, so almost 17 I did weights till about 2 years ago. So I did weights mostly, you know, a bit of pull-ups, weight pull-ups here and there, but mostly weights till I was about 20, 21. Then I started calisthenics, but I was still doing weights. But that grew my back a lot. Then once I started doing calisthenics about properly, you know, skills was like 23, 24. So that blew up my shoulders, my biceps a bit more, and yeah, many of those two, my triceps like were all strong. So yeah, I feel like weights helped with a lot, but then back, shoulders, biceps, calisthenics grew mostly. Yeah. So I did weights when I was growing up, but then the last 2 years is only skills. Only skills, but like, you know, here and there I do reps and sets. Depends on my goal. Right, I don't know what else we do, guys. Ooh, we're basically done. I think I have one more set. I think I have one more set of these. I think that will be it for today, because I'm super tired. I feel like it was good. We did some pull-up presses, which I'm very happy about. You know what? I'll do one more set of these presses. One more set. Then we'll answer some final questions. And we're done. I just thought of another exercise that really helped me when I started learning calisthenics, which was these. It helped my shoulders. So I'd grab a resistance band. I'd do one lighter than this when I started. I'd stand on it, press like that, and I would just hold here till I couldn't anymore. That really helped my shoulders. And I'll try and protract and depress while I did it. Another good one. So this can help with presses or holds. At the end of the workout, I did this almost every time. And that like at the end of the workout, that kills. Like I feel it in my back and my shoulders and my biceps. I know, man. Yeah, my neighbors must think, yeah, what the fuck. Because it's not even any music playing out loud, it's all in my headphones, so it's like I'm just shouting. I know. Your traps dominate the movement? Yeah, yeah, I guess it depends what goal it is. Because now I'm doing them for presses. But before, it was all shoulders. When I would just hold here, if you really bring your shoulder blades forward and retract, it all goes to the front delt. Like, you see that? Like, if I move there, it's all front delt. Until I get up here, then it's traps. Here to here is traps, and a little bit front delt. But, yeah, from that bottom bit, it's my shoulders doing the work. At least for me. So only train skills, will that give you muscles? I mean, if you progressively overload. I think if you do enough volume, if you do enough, because it's not only about progressive overload, it's not only about making it harder. It's also about the amount you're doing. Because I could do only two sets of my planche hold and make it harder each week. Because it's only two sets, I'm not gonna really grow from that. If I do enough, so 15 sets a week, for example, 16 sets a week, if I'm progressively overloading as well, and maybe it's a muscle I've not trained before, then yeah. But for example, my triceps, I don't think they've grown much in the last year. I think my triceps have been the same size. They maybe got leaner, but my triceps have still been the same. But my biceps have gotten bigger, I think, a little bit. And my shoulders definitely have blown up just from the amount of volume. So it's more about volume than volume and progressive overload than just overload. Yeah, make sure your nutrition is on point. Yeah, like Option says, options come through the knowledge. Option coming through the knowledge. What was I saying these? So this again. So also your accessories. Your accessories are where you can go more volume, less intensity, and grow. Like for example, this is not really strength. It's more hypertrophy and, you know, and neuroadaptation, like your nervous system. Probably going a bit quick on this, but I felt good. No worries, man. Oh. Right, we're coming to the end, guys. I've got a few more sets left, so you know, leave your questions. You know, I'll answer them. Yeah, let me know if you've enjoyed the stream. Leave a like, and if you're new, you're watching. I'm doing these streams every week. At least twice a week, I think, it's going to be the aim. So if you like it, you train calisthenics, or you want to start, you can always hop in here, ask questions, because there's not a lot of people you can really ask without paying them. So let me know. Do you plan on opening your own Cali gym when you get big? I mean, that's banking on like getting big, I don't know. That sounds like one in a million thing. Having that kind of capital to invest in a gym and buy the space. I hadn't thought about that at all. You know, maybe one day. I've not really thought about it, man. W stream, thank you, Sammy. Next stream might be Sunday. Next stream might be Sunday. Yeah, Sunday or next Tuesday, maybe. What day is Sunday? Oh, that's New Year. No, wait. Saturday, Sunday. Yeah, that's New Year's Day. Maybe New Year's Day. Maybe. Depends what I end up doing on New Year's. So either Sunday or Tuesday. W stream, W guide, W sport, W channel, W content. Thank you, man. Thank you. Right. Let's do this yellow band. Let's go. Let's make the final set a good one. Three, two. To be fair, those are quite similar to Zanetti press, but I like these more. Okay guys, thank you so much for joining me today. Where do I start if I'm female? It really depends on how strong you are, because like, you know, some girls can already hold up their body weight, so can you hold up your body weight or can you pull your body weight? If not, that's the place to start. Start working on push-ups, so pushing your body weight and being able to hold up your body weight in a plank, or being able to pull your body weight. So being able to do rows, Australian rows, or bent leg, bent knee, Australian rows, all places to start. So you've got to work on holding up your body weight or pushing your body weight and pulling your body weight. And also hanging, so just being able to hold your body weight. You can go to a climbing gym, that will help. So all places to start if you're, you know, not even just female, just a beginner and want to start calisthenics. I do the same, but it's hollow body and each hand 2 kg and locked arms. Yeah, yeah. It's basically Zanetti press. I personally prefer this over Zanetti because I can really feel it in my shoulders and I can press directly overhead and you know, still feel it. Yeah, but both are good. Respect the effort you put in your stream, thank you. Alright guys, if there's no more questions, thank you so much for joining me in the stream. I'll stream again, you know, either Sunday or Tuesday. I do personal coaching, personal training. If you want help with calisthenics, check out the YouTube channel membership. Links in the description. The Maltese members. The Maltese members, they get personal training. I make the programs and we check in every month at minimum, sometimes more. So yeah, if you're looking to get personal coaching, and it's really cheap, to be fair. It's only going to be cheap for maybe the first half of 2023. Then I'm probably going to kind of close it off a bit because I'm helping quite a lot of people. It's quite hard at the moment. So it's probably going to be cheap quite a bit longer and then the price will go up for it. So you can check it out. It's only like £20 a month for personal coaching, which is like absurdly cheap. You guys don't even understand. So I'd say take advantage of that if you want help. If not, join the Discord. Discord free. Just check the link down below. You'll join the Discord. Then you can post to people that will help you. I'm in there as well. Active every day. So join the Discord. If not, just like the channel, subscribe to the channel because I'm streaming. I'm also making content as well. Got that front lever video coming for you guys as well. Yeah, no worries for answering the questions, mine. You're getting motivated? Yeah, hell yeah, man. Julius, get it. Everyone, happy new year in advance. Yeah, happy new years, guys, if I don't see you. Have accessible goals. For this year, yeah, let's get the planches, let's get the pull-ups, let's get the rows, let's get the front lever, let's get all of it. Hell yeah, guys. Alright. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I will see you probably in the new year, either Sunday or Tuesday. So thanks so much for watching, guys. In a bit. And yeah, make sure you join the Discord.